Let's turn in our Bibles to the book of Acts chapter 27. We want to read from verse
9.
The Bible says, "Now much time was spent, and when sailing was now dangerous, because the fast was now already past, Paul admonished them."
Zvino nguva huru yakati yapfuura nokufamba mugungwa kwavo kwakakwava nenjodzi nokuti nguva yekuzvinyima zvokudya yakanga yapfuura, Paulo akavarayira.
And he said unto them, "Sirs, I perceive that this voyage will be with hurt and much damage, not only of the lading and ship, but also of our lives."
Akati kwavari, "Varume, ndinoona kuti rwendo rwedu ruchava nekutambudzika nokurasikirwa kukuru, zvisati zviri zvinhu zviri muno nechikepe chibedzi, asi neupenyu hweduwo."
And verse 11, "Nevertheless, the centurion believed the master and the owner of the ship more than those things which were spoken by Paul."
Asi mukuru wezana akateverera zvakataurwa nemuchikairi wechikepe nomwene wacho kupfuura zvakanga zvarehwa naPaulo.
Right, the subject is sailing through treacherous waters. Life itself is like sailing.
Upenyu pachawo hwakafanana nekufamba mumvura.
It's like you are sailing through the sea. And if you are going to be sailing, you will need a guide. You will need somebody who knows, who understands the waters. Amen.
Amen.
You will need somebody who has an understanding of the temperaments of the sea. Amen.
Amen.
You will also need a map. Because when you go out in the sea there, it comes to a point where there is nothing else you see except the sea. No mountains. No lights. Nothing else. You can't depend on feeling then. You need a map. And on top of a map, you need a compass. The map is the Bible. The compass is the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
And then above all these things, you need an anchor. Something that can hold you in a position. Now, if we go back to our scriptures, you are going to see, we are told here was a man who had a true spiritual experience and a true calling, a true commission and a true anointing and a true vindication.
Chitiko chemuya chaicho chemachokwadi nekudanwa kwemachokwadi nechizoro chemachokwadi nekutumwa kwemachokwadi nekusimbiswa kwemachokwadi.
And here is a centurion,
epano mukuru wezana zvakare,
a man in charge of 100 soldiers.
Munhu ari kunotungamira mauto zana.
That is what he is, where he works.
Ndozvaari kwaanoshanda.
Many people, when they come to the things of God, they have an interference of their profession and the work they are doing in life. If he is a driver of a 30-ton lorry, he thinks you can drive in the scriptures the way you drive a gonyet. If he's a pilot, he comes with the pilot experience. And the other one was the owner of the ship. He said, "This is my ship. My ship is not going that way. It's going this way." Why? He said, "Because it's my ship." We have people here that come, but they have already the way they want to be helped. And when neither sun nor stars in many days appeared, and no small tempest lay on us, all hope that we should be saved was taken away. All hope was lost of being saved. They've tried every trick in and out of the book, and day and night it was just constant storm. The sun did not appear. The moon did not appear. The stars did not appear. It was darkness through and through. And nobody even ate. There are people that have reached that stage where everything is just cocky. There seems to be no way out. And then in verse 21, "But after long abstinence, Paul stood forth in the midst of them and said, 'Sirs, you should have hearkened unto me.'" And not have lost from Crete, and to have gained this harm and loss. I like people who know who they are. You must stay with this word and stay with us until you know what you are and who you are, and you know who God is. Then you know how to behave in extreme crises. You know very well that God has his eyes upon you. We are sailing through treacherous waters, and it is the worst time that the world has ever passed through. But we have a promise in that hour that when things are that bad, those who know their God, they will not be shaken. They don't fear and they don't bother. They will say, "I'm in the barrel. If I have to die, the angels will take me home. But if I'm here, I'm tormenting the devil." Hallelujah! We are in a mission here. We are here to represent the kingdom of God. Those who know their God, they will be strong. Hallelujah! When Peter came,
Peter Pakawe,
when he came to the presence of Jesus,
Pakawe,
he didn't know who he was. He just thought he was a hopeless fisherman. But one day, when he knew who Jesus was, when he said, "You are Christ the Messiah," Jesus turned and said, "Thou art Cephas. You are a stone. I give you the keys of heaven, the keys of the kingdom." When you know your God, you begin to carry some keys. The key is the answer and the solution. When things are so bad, when every light is out, the keys are still hanging there. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah.
Peter was told, "I give you the keys to the kingdom. Whatever you bind, if you say storm stop, the storm will stop. Whatever you bind here on earth will be bound in heaven." That happens only when you know your God. When you know him, you must know his character. You must know his ways. You must know what annoys him and what makes him happy. You must know his behavior. Then he must prove you that you really mean to walk with him. Shall two walk together except they be agreed? When Peter said, "I know who you are," the keys were given. And then he got his identity. Jesus said, You are no longer a Simeon. A new name. That no one else can read. Except you. You begin to know yourself different from the way people know you. Let them call you whatever they want to call you. But when you know who you are, in moments like this, in times of a crisis, he was able to rise up. This man who was called Saul, when he knew his God, he was given a new name, which was Paul. In times of a crisis, he stood up and said, "Sirs, you should have listened to me. You could have avoided this trouble. However, it's not too late. Even from now, even now, I've got the keys. Even now, with what you're going through, with what has happened, we have the keys. Fear not, only believe." Hallelujah. And if you listen to what Paul said. He said, and there was silence. The centurion was silent. The owner of the ship was silent. And all the other dignitaries were silent. And Paul was talking, pacing up and down the floor. And he said, "Now I exhort you. I am exhorting you to be of good cheer. For there shall be no loss of any man's life among you but the sheep."
And because of your argument.
"For there stood by me this night the angel of God, whose I am and who I serve." Do you know who you belong to? Do you know whom you serve? And the angel has said, "Fear not, Paul. Thou must be brought before Caesar. And lo, God hath given thee all them that sail with thee. And the Mwari aona kuti zvingakurwadze kuti ko vanokufa seiko vaneni vanokufireiko nofira here nharo dzewoyoyo newoyoyo chipi ngaiparare zvayo asi vanhu ndipei.
God said that it would hate you to see these people dying once they are with you. Shall they die because they are hot yet among them? Let the sheep perish, but let these people be saved.
Amen.
Amen.
When we are sailing through treacherous waters, we need to know who we are. These are the end times. The world has become a combat zone. The lid of hell was lifted up, and there is demonic presences. There is evil demons that are on earth that's never been allowed to be on earth. They are so wicked that they are turning your boys into gays. Those people are not being funny. It's a spirit. Pastors becoming gays. Sodomizing people in church. Things are very bad. We are sailing in that kind of situation. Unclean spirits making pastors do hideous things. And you wonder what's wrong with the man. Shipwreck. When a man is shipwrecked, he doesn't know what to do. It's shipwreck. Message I didn't put it that in. No,
the message we are preaching.
I is homemade. Aiwa, ishobora mwari chaire God's resting for the end time. Let every combat come. Tinoti ngaiuye.
Say come.
Ngaiuye.
We welcome it.
Tinenge tichiona.
Atifambire
mberi.
Hey,
that treacherous hour.
Munguva yakaipisisa.
That tremendous time that we are living in. This time is a tremendous time. What made John the greatest of all the prophets that's ever been? Because that's what Jesus said. He said, of all those born of a woman, there's not been one greater than John. And yet John never performed even one miracle. But his position, he was the last link. He was the one that was to summarize all the things that's been said about the Messiah and put it all together and put the conclusion that this is the Messiah. If it had been a treacherous person, he could have said the wrong thing about the Messiah. Can we say amen to that? Our position requires us to be straight and stick and say the right thing about this message and about this Messiah and about the millennium and about all that, which is why we are offered that the overcomer in this age will sit on the throne. Do you know that a witness is very, very important? A witness. John was the witness. The last runner. When in a relay, no matter how well the other runners have run, if the last one gets that button stick, then he says, yeah, it I prayed, it you can't pass it.
Do any tricks and I'll throw it down.
That's why they are all resting on us. Musakande pasi, manya nacho, usakande.
That's why we are going to tell you, Patiri, don't throw it down. Run with it. Don't throw it down.
Yes, they've created all the advantage for us. We don't even have to do anything but just run gently and get there. But if we drop it, everything goes wrong. That's why they are depending on us. That's what makes us important. That's why we must know who we are and what we are here for. Don't drop this message. Don't drop the standards. Don't drop the faith. Stay in line.
Hallelujah.
Think about it. The position of John. The most important day for him was that day when he was baptizing. He had been looking for that day because it was the climax of all climaxes. He had never met Jesus in the flesh, but he had been told, the Holy Ghost will show you. Stay true to the Holy Ghost and you will not miss the rapture. Stay on your post of duty and you will not miss the rapture. He stayed on the post of duty in the times of drought when there wasn't much to eat. He still was there. And then one day, as he saw Jesus coming, the Holy Ghost came and said, John, you've done a good job. That's him. He called all his disciples. He says, this is the greatest moment of my time. All that I've lived for is for this moment. This is the Messiah. That's the one. Do you know there's something that you must do that no one else can do? There are people that are resting on you to identify to them the Messiah. How do you show them the Messiah? People are saying, let us see Jesus. Where can they see him? Except in your own life. That's why this message, this quotation, it says this is a treacherous hour where you can make a terrible mistake. But it is the most tremendous time, the most glorious time, most glorious than old ages, because we are facing the millennium. The great millennium.
Millennium.
1,000 years of no sickness, no inflation, no jail, no pain, no sorrow, no hunger, no storm. Even the cattle won't fight. That's what you are facing. Rise up, true Christians. There's no greater honor than to be given to be the last witness of this great millennium. And you must witness of it by your own life. The life that you live is the greatest witness that you can give. Any of the things you do, you are testifying because you are right now under the influence of your inheritance. You are under the influence of things that are to be. What are the things that are to be? The millennium. Eden again. A 1,000 years here on earth. True love. True joy, true peace, true brotherhood, That's what's about to come. But before it comes, the devil is contending. He's contending left, right, and center. And if he can find a weakness among the believers. But in this game, it takes more than sincerity. It will take the word to defeat Satan.
Satan.